So YouTube is rolling out the foreign language audio dubbing feature for creators. Let's talk about it. So I have two primary YouTube channels and have been waiting for audio dubbing for a long time. They first announced this about 3 or 4 years ago, and since then it's been delayed quite a few different times. But then the other day, kind of like an early Christmas present, there it was, and I'm sorry, but I can't show the notification that I saw. Unfortunately, I dismissed that notification before I screen captured it. But there's another way to check for it. So you can just go to settings, and then you can go to upload defaults, then advanced settings. And if your channel has this, then there will be a new section that's called automatic dubbing, like you can see here, where you can choose to either allow it or manually review it, or just manually review dubs in experimental languages. Now, unfortunately, this doesn't work for videos that you've already uploaded and published, whether they're published or unlisted, for example. The dubbing will only work for net new uploads, but you can re-upload a video. For example, if you have one that's maybe sitting unpublished, unlisted, in a queue or kind of staging right now, you can basically pull that down and re-upload a new one and use all of its attributes. So it's kind of quick in terms of bringing in the title and the description and all those things. And if you've been waiting for this like I have, the good news is that this is on by default. You shouldn't need to toggle any controls unless you want to allow those experimental languages. So once your new video is done uploading, or even existing videos, you can see this as well. But if you go into the new languages menu, you'll see that at the top, there's the native language controls that you can either use them to edit or upload subtitles. Now, an important thing to note here is if you want to initiate the dubbing, if your channel language is in English like mine, it happens only once you either clean up the automatically generated captions manually or upload new captions of your own. And the timing to process your video is going to vary quite a bit. So I've noticed, for example, that video processing times, you know, for my larger channel with around 350,000 subs takes less than half the time that it takes on this channel, for example. So I'm going to fast forward for about an hour to show you what YouTube does. So if I go back in the new languages page, you'll see that there are language entries now for French, German, Hindi, Indonesian, Italian, Japanese, Portuguese, and Spanish. A few of these have dialects. Now remember our experimental option in settings. Well, that's where you see that for Hindi and Indonesian and Japanese. And the audio tab says whether they've been published or in draft mode, aka if you did leave the defaults for experimental languages, then you would need to approve them manually. So one observation I had here was that I was a little bit surprised to see Italian and Japanese given the traffic patterns of my two channels, which have quite low viewership, to be honest, in terms of Italian viewers and Japanese viewers. But having spent some time in both of those countries, the fluency locally there in English is a bit rarer than much of Europe or Asia or South America, so it does make sense. And by the way, I don't expect everyone to speak English, you know, like some people actually do. One of my university majors was German language, foreign language, and I'm fluent in that and also have lived in Germany. And I'm also somewhat fluent in Mandarin Chinese, having lived around 5 years in Shanghai. And by the way, as a channel owner, you can also preview the content that's been dubbed into these languages. Now notice that the subtitles have not been added here, and I'll come back to that in a second. For now, I'll click on German because I can understand that one best. And you'll see the title's been translated, but not the description. Now, I actually didn't add one before during my upload, so maybe it might have been translated if I did that during the actual upload process. I'll need to test that out next time. Then under subtitles, you can see a little music symbol with a dub label. Now it shows that they are automatic and in this case published, but using the dropdown, you can flip between published and draft or vice versa. Then under the ellipse, you can see that you can delete the language track as well. Now on the right, it's going to default to the selection of original audio, and you can also use the dropdown to preview the video in the selected language, German in my case here. And this particular video doesn't have any underlying music, but I've tested this on my other channel, and it actually leaves the non-vocal audio there as well. So let's play this one for a minute.
In Ordnung, ich habe also nach einer guten tragbaren Kamera gesucht. Noch einmal. Okay, ich habe also nach einer großartigen tragbaren Kamera gesucht, mit der ich sowohl unterwegs filmen kann, eine Art Vlogging-Kamera, als auch nach etwas, das ich über USB-C anschließen kann und das sogar etwas kleiner ist als meine Sony Alpha Kameras.
And as a German speaker and foreign language major, I'll share a few thoughts. So not every language has the same speed and the same cadence as each other. So it kind of speeds up and slows down to keep in line with the original language of the video itself. So having lived in Germany, the language dubbing, it's kind of an art form. Oftentimes, production studios will nearly match the lip movement of the actors, and basically they'll actually refine the talk track, the dialogue between them, in order to match the lip movement, the cadence of speech, and even the mood of the scene, for example, to make sure that it all fits together. Those are aspects of professional dubbing that you don't see here, but that said, at least in German and given my level in the language, the translation seems to be pretty accurate. And automatic language translation for a long time, I will say, was pretty terrible when I moved back and forth between English and German. And it still isn't perfect, but by not really trying too hard to match the lip movement and the cadence, it's at least crystal clear if you're watching this that this is an automated voice dub, and it keeps the expectations kind of the viewer about the accuracy a bit lower than it would have been if it was, say, manually dubbed. But you might be wondering, what's the viewer experience like? So now let's take a look at the experience then if you are viewing this video in other languages. And this will work, by the way, if you want to test it out on an unlisted video. So now I'm going to go ahead and hit play, then I'll come back to that menu. There we go. And I'll go ahead and flip through each of these languages for a few seconds.
Juga sesuatu yang bisa disambungkan. Leggi tramite USB-C che sia un po' più piccola persino delle mie videocamere Sony Alpha.
Au moment où vous mettez un objectif et faites la carte de capture USB et emportez l'appareil photo avec vous, cela prend une quantité considérable de bagages, si vous
fazendo as malas ou viajando internacionalmente ou esse tipo de coisa.
Esta cámara que estás viendo aquí es la Canon PowerShot V10, y la conecto mediante USB-C usando el modo de cámara web de la cámara a mi entorno.
さて, SD メディアに撮影して記録する場合は, 最大 4K30fps または 1080p60 60 aufnehmen. Aber über USB-C bin ich im Grunde auf 1080p 30 Bilder pro Sekunde beschränkt. In Bezug auf die Einstellungen habe ich den Autofokus.
करेतो मैंने ऑटोफोकस को अपनी आंखों के आसपास के एरिया पर सेट किया है क्योंकि यह थोड़ा हंटिंग कर रहा था और माइक्रोफोन दरअसल बिल्ट इन माइक्रोफोन है और मैं हाल ही में इसका काफी
I gotta say when I first saw this I loved it but I'm not completely sure how accurate the other languages are outside of German to be honest. Let me give you a few tips though if you're looking for accuracy. First, you'll want to capitalize things like proper nouns and product names for example. Because those can often be known by their English brand names in other countries. And sometimes YouTube will also assume some words are proper nouns and brands when they're not. So uncapitalize those words if you find them. And make sure that you use punctuation to form normal sentences, even though kind of in normal spoken English and also in other languages, it's very common to use run-on sentences. Just start making sure that you clean up your captions with these checks to give machine translation the best chance that you can in order to be accurate. And there are a few things that I hope do come to this service later. First would be the ability to upload your own audio tracks in the supported and other languages, for example, if you wanted to be able to go the extra mile and either record your own voice if you do speak another language or try to match the cadence. Now, second, for accessibility, I wish there was an option to add a descriptive audio track, at least in the video's native language. That said though, this is an awesome first step, and I think there's a lot more to come. I'll be using this, and this video should have it enabled too, by the way, if you want to try it out. Now, especially if you speak multiple languages, tell me in the comments how accurate it is in terms of its dubbing. And as always, thanks so much for watching.